In this video, we'll look at using the new Modify SAS Code Content Assessment application to update hard-coded paths within our SAS programs in preparation for a modernization to SAS Viya. SAS 9.4 Content Assessment is a collection of applications designed to help you understand various characteristics of your SAS 9.4 system. It's intended to help you prepare for a transition to Viya. It's downloadable from support.sas.com and it will run on any SAS 9.4 release on Linux, AIX or Windows. We have another YouTube video, SAS 9 Content Assessment, that shows you the details of running and getting the results from Content Assessment. Recently, Content Assessment has evolved to add new applications that go further than assessment and help you with performing a migration. One such application is the new Modify SAS Code applications. For SAS 9.4 customers with many SAS programs, the file paths in their programs will most likely be different on Viya and Kubernetes, especially if you're going from a Windows environment to a Linux environment which Viya on Kubernetes runs on. Modify SAS Code has been developed to support updating the paths within these programs as part of a batch process, so you don't have to do it individually in each program. As a prerequisite to running Modify SAS Code, you must have run the CodeCheck Content Assessment application. CodeCheck analyzes your SAS code for elements that are potentially incompatible with SAS Viya and for any hard-coded paths that may need to be updated so that the code will run on Viya. Then Modify SAS Code, using some of the input from CodeCheck, is able to update the hard-coded paths in a copy of your SAS code. In addition, when it does this, it writes some inline documentation to that source code so you can identify where any changes have been made. Alright, let's see it in action. In the demo, I'm going to review the CodeCheck report. I will then use Modify Code to generate an initial CSV mapping file. We will modify the CSV mapping file and map the old paths to the new path. And following that, we'll take a look at the modified SAS code to make sure it's accurate and to see the changes that have been made. Okay, let's get started with the demo. First, I'm going to look at the CodeCheck report. Here I have a CodeCheck that I've run against a particular directory, and it has output for the files from the directory. I've given it the tag YouTube base SAS code, so that's the tag. And you can see if I select live name, I have in my file some hard-coded live names, I have some hard-coded path assignments. The output shows me what line number and what file it's in and what the statement is, and I have some hard-coded file names. So these are things that are going to have to change when I move over to my Viya 4 environment. So we'll switch over and run the Modify Code tool. One of the first things we have to do is generate the map file. So if we run Modify SAS Code generate map, give it the name for the file, and we pass it our scan tag. If we run that, it's going to generate a CSV mapping file from the scanned code that was in the scan tag YouTube's SAS code, which was a directory on our file system. So I've completed that step. We go look at that file now. It's in the content assessment directory with the name that I gave it, which is gelcoremap.csv. This file has a row for each unique line of code with a hard-coded path that was discovered by the CodeCheck application. And then it shows a column with the old path, a column with the new path, and the original line which is there for your information. You can see that the old path and the new path are the same right now, but that's something we're going to have to update. We're going from a Windows environment to a Unix environment. So at this point, I need to know what my target path would be, so I can edit this file and populate the new path column so that when I run the tool again, it maps the old path to the new path. Before we run the tool again, let's take a look at the code. It's in this directory here. I have five files. I'll open one of the files and we'll just look at what's going on. I have a macro variable there that was identified with a path. I have a percent include also on line 10 that was identified with a path. So those are things that are going to have to change. The next step then is to update the mapping file. What we want to do is update the new path to the path that is going to be in our Viaphor environment. So that's going to be a Linux path. We'll do that for row 2 and for row 5 through 8. And for rows 3 and 4, we will delete them from the mapping CSV file because they reference macro variables. And when the macro variable setting is updated, then the macro variable should be read correctly and be a Linux path. So we don't actually need to do any mapping on those rows. So we'll go ahead and do that. This is a file that's already been updated. You can see in the second row, the old path is Windows and the new path is Linux, and the same in the other rows. So we've mapped a Windows path to a Linux path, and we're going to pass that to the Modify Code application to make those updates in a copy of the code. If we switch over to the command line again, then we'll run modify SAS code, and this time we will do the modify, which will take the code, process the mapping file, make the changes in the mapping file, and write the code out to a new location. So I pass it the scan tag, the path to the map file, and the output location for our code. And press enter, and it should run through the process. I get some messages in the window to tell me what it's doing. Looks like it was successful. I have a note there to say I have a log. Let's go take a look at the log, which is written inside the content assessment directory and has some useful information in it. So here's my log. If I open it up, there's a lot of information at the top, but there's some key information down the bottom where it actually tells us what it's doing. So it's processing this file, potential lines to be updated, it notes them, and it tells you what change it has made in the lines that it does update. So here it's changing the Windows path to the new Linux path. So good information in the log about what's happening. And it's very important to check that after you've run modify SAS code. We can now also go over and take a look at what happens within the code. You can see a copy of the code has been made in our new code location that we specified in modify SAS code. And the directory structure of the original location is recreated there. And here's the files that have been updated. Let's look at one of them. We can see that modify SAS code writes a comment to document the change that has been made. In this case, in the macro variable assignment, we didn't make any changes to the lib name where it uses the macro variable. And then there's a second change there, which updated the path in the percent include. So modify SAS code has gone through and created a copy of the code and made the changes in the code to update the hard-coded paths. So in this brief demo, we've done this for 5 SAS programs in a directory, but you can see how if you have many SAS programs and a lot of hard-coded paths, how this would make your life a lot easier. At this point, you have a copy of the code that potentially would run in Via. It would also be very important to test that code at this point to make sure that it does run in Via before you put it into production.